Welcome to Feiwei International Church, to this English worship service. Father God, we thank you for your presence. Father God, be enthroned above our praise and worship, in the midst of the angels and all the 24 elders, and with the four living creatures in the presence of the Lord God. This is time that we would be brought into the third heaven, and in Christ Jesus, that we may sit at the right hand of God, and that as we behold the Lamb, we can now rise and bow down to worship Him. As we are standing on the glassy sea by the blood of the Lamb, He is worthy of all of our praise and worship. Hallelujah. We're going to take a look at the scripture in Revelation chapter 4. Revelation chapter 4, beginning from verse 3. Father God, we thank you. Yes, Lord. Thank you that your presence is right here with us. And as we worship you in truth and in spirit, we pray that you will reveal yourself unto us. For great is the glory of the Lord. Hallelujah. We welcome you in Jesus' mighty name into the presence of the Lord, the living one, and worship him. Revelation chapter 4, from verse 3. And the one who sat there, that's a throne, they appear before him. The Apostle John, a throne, and there one who was set there had the appearance of jasper and carnelian. A rainbow resembling an emerald encircled the throne. That's speaking about the light that comes forth. Jesus is the light of God, and he is salvation. Surrounding the throne were 24 other thrones, and seated on them were 24 elders. They were dressed in white and had crowns of gold on their heads. From the throne came flashes of lightning, rumblings, and peals of thunder. Before the throne, seven lamps were blazing. These are the seven spirits of God. And as we come before this holy presence of the Lord God, we are to worship him in truth and in spirit. The 24 elders fell down before him who sits on the throne, and worship him who lives forever and ever. They lay their crowns before the throne and say, "You are worthy, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honor and power. For you created all things, and by your will they were created and have their being." Thank you, Father, for your presence. Thank you, Lord. Now we welcome everyone in Jesus' name to come together to worship him. And open up your hearts to him, because this is the season, God says, "I will appear to you and I will come to you." So prepare yourself, open up yourself to surrender before him and let him come and visit you. In Jesus' name, amen. Even the angelic hosts of the living God are surrounding, and also they are bowing down to worship the Lord together with us. Let's worship him from your heart.
Thank you. of all of our praise and worship. Hallelujah. Jesus is the Lamb that was slain, but He brought triumph.
Looking as if
heaven, we worship you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We declare that, Lord, you deserve the glory.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
You deserve
the glory, Lord, Father God. God, and you are the only one. And we give you praise, glory, honor, and worship.
Thank you. to the Lord our God in heaven. And thank you, Father God, that your throne is established above our praise and worship. And now may the Lord Jesus be enthroned in our hearts. As the greatest, he is the only Savior, he is the only Messiah, Jesus Yeshua HaMashiach, the Lamb of God that was slain. And by his blood, we were washed clean, and that we can have eternal life. It is through the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father God. We cannot thank you enough for the Lamb of God that was slain, who can present us to stand before your throne, standing on the glassy sea, that we may behold your beauty and your glory. Father, Lord, we thank you. Thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And now we are going to worship by giving unto the Lord. Let's take a look at this scripture. We're going to turn to 1 Chronicles chapter 29 from verse 9. And let us prepare our hearts to worship him by giving unto the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. First Chronicles chapter 29 from verse 9. Now it says here, the people rejoiced at the willing response of their leaders, for they had given freely and wholeheartedly to the Lord. The giving unto the Lord is freely and wholeheartedly. Why? Because we are celebrating the greatness and the goodness of God. David the king also rejoiced greatly. David praised the Lord in the presence of the whole assembly, saying, "Praise be to you, O Lord, God of our father Israel, from everlasting to everlasting. Yours, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the majesty and the splendor. For everything in heaven and earth is yours. Yours, O Lord, is the kingdom. You are exalted as head over all. Wealth and honor come from you. You are the ruler of all things. In your hands are strength and power to exalt and to give strength to all. Now, our God, we give you thanks and praise your glorious name." And it is time to give unto the Lord. But who am I and who are my people that we should be able to give as generously as this? Everything comes from you, and we have given you only what comes from your hand. What we give to worship the Lord, they are all the increases that the Lord has blessed us with. Let's turn to the offering page. As we surrender ourselves unto him to worship the Lord, the Lord has spoken his promise for everyone who is a tither. We stand as a tither because we render back to God his holy tithes, which is the first 10% of everything. And that, Father God, now you would open up your windows of heaven and you'll pour down so much blessings unto us that we don't even have room enough to contain. Yes, Lord, we decree this upon us as we obey your word by rendering to you your holy tithes. And you will rebuke the devourer for our sake. You pour out blessings unto us from your open heaven, and that we don't even have room enough to contain. Father God, yes, we bless to see this reality in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh yes, in the now and in the present, in the name of Jesus. And Father God will rebuke the devourer for our sake. Lord, we thank you that you cause the fruits of our planting to not cast before their time, and that nations shall call us blessed. We are the land that the Lord delights in. In the name of Jesus, I release this blessing now for everyone who is a tither, who returns back to God his holy tithe. And now, I'm going to speak a blessing over everyone who is giving unto the Lord, sowing to him, worshiping him, in the principle of seed time and harvest. As you release a seed unto the Lord, so shall you be able to receive a harvest from him. And as you receive a harvest from him, it shall be pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Shall men pour back into your laps with the measure that you measure to the Lord. With the same measure, it shall be measured back to you. Hallelujah. And I bless 30, 60, and 100-fold. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I see bushels the blessings of the Lord so big coming upon us who are His children. In Jesus' name, amen. The Lord is faithful. Yes. And for those who are giving by e-transfer, you can designate, you can write us an email first. And our email address is favorinternationalchurch@gmail.com. F-A-V-O-R. favorinternationalchurch@gmail.com. And then you can send it and designate the items that you wanted to sew into. And then you click it over and it shall be done. Now, for those who are writing a check to Favor Church, please write Favor International. And only in the English name, Favor International, okay? Please don't write the Chinese name. It's Favor International, you can bracket church. And then you can send it to our mailbox. Now that you have planted, you shall receive a harvest of plenty, which is at least 30 or 60 or 100-fold. The reason is Father God is faithful to keep watch over His words. What He has instructed, what He has delivered, He shall watch to perform. We can trust in Him because He is faithful God. We thank You, Father God, for the increase. Create in us a heart of thanksgiving and give us wisdom to manage. Give us wisdom to know how to multiply and put the right resources into the right places according to the blessed will of God. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Amen. Now, this is a powerful message because the Lord is speaking to us for year 5783. We have come into 5783 since September the 25th of this year. And this calendar year will go through year 2022 into 2023 up to September the 23rd. So in this year, God is saying, prepare yourself to launch out because My presence goes with you. Now, the Lord is saying, He is appearing to us. This is the season that Father God wants to appear to us so that you may encounter Him. He comes to allow you to encounter Him. So Father God, I speak this blessing and I declare this is the season that Father God is calling us to encounter Him. Thank You, Father God, for Your greatness and for this beautiful, beautiful goodness that comes through from You, because You wanted to come meet with us and You wanted us to come into Your presence to the throne room of God so that we may receive helps in times of trouble, so that we may come boldly without fear, so that we may come in the name of Jesus Christ, bearing worship and praise and thanksgiving as we come into the courts of the Lord God, so that Father God will rejoice in seeing us, the children, coming forth, believing Him. Yes, this is the season where God is going to come and magnify Himself to you. And when you see Him pass by, when you see the opportunity, it is called the divine opportune time. When you see that, don't miss it. I bless in Jesus' name that we will not miss it. Father God, it is Your good will to pass through that we may see Jesus and to know Your word and to grab hold of the word and let the word lead us all the way into Your abundant blessings, into Your presence, and to worship You. We are so thankful for year 5783 because You shall reward us. And as we come into Your presence, we shall receive a divine plan from God as to how to live, what to do, where to go, what to say, and be connected to the right group of people for divine prosperity and blessing, so that we may win many souls for the Lord Jesus Christ and for the glory of the Lord our God. We thank You, Holy Spirit, for Your work in our midst. We give You praise, glory, and honor. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. So Father God is saying, I want to come and I want to encounter You. Now, this "and He appeared" is for this week. In this particular week, we shall encounter the Lord. Genesis chapter 13, we're going to look at the scripture from verse 3 And here it says, this is concerning Abraham. Abraham is the father of faith. Now, Abraham said, now let's turn to Genesis chapter 13. These are the, what I call the points I'm going to mention later on. Let's look at Genesis chapter 18. And we know that on that powerful day, Abraham was sitting in the hot sun, you know, in front of his tent. The Lord appeared to Abraham near the great trees of Mamre while he was sitting at the entrance to his tent in the heat of the day. Now, in the heat of the day could mean a few things. Besides the physical, literally hot, you know, in the heat of your day, he will appear to you. Hallelujah. Tree of Mamre, where Abraham had set an altar to worship the Lord before. So it is at the place of worship that Father God is going to manifest himself to you. So my encouragement to you is keep worshiping the Lord, studying the scripture, understanding what God wants for you for every day, as Jesus in Mark chapter 1 from 35 to 37, as Jesus himself would go to a quiet place and he would pray. And then when the multitudes came with Peter, you know, Peter with lots of people are looking for him and said, they are waiting for you. And Jesus said, no. No, I need to go over to the other city and I must preach over there because this is why I come. Now he is not attending to the needs of the people right away, immediately there. Why? Because he is following God's agenda in order that he may save the whole world and deliver the whole world to come away and out from any sickness and disease and sin. So God has his blessed plan to know how to save and deliver his people. So study that scripture, call out to him and wait on him. Yes, in your worship time, God will appear to you at the place of worship. Abraham looked up and saw. Now this is spiritual seeing. Everybody say, my spiritual eyes are opened. Lord, Father God, open my spiritual eyes that I may see. Amen? Yes. Now he looked up and he saw three men standing by. That's Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. When he saw them, he hurried from the entrance of his tent to meet with them, bow low to the ground. See, once you encounter God, you will not miss it because he comes to you. Everybody say, God is coming for me. And God is coming toward me. And that God is coming so that I may bear the mark of his blessing. Amen? Because he wants to come to bless. Oh, everyone in Faith International Church. Now you need to watch and you need to discern. Because this is the time Father God wants to come and meet with us, visit us, and bring forth his blessings. Now he said, if I have found favor in your eyes, my Lord, do not pass your servant by. This is the key for today. We know that God is coming forth toward each one of us. Please learn to host his presence like Abraham. Everybody say this. I need to learn to host the presence of the Lord God. I need to know how to entertain God and give him precedence and give him my all priority, my attention. As you worship, focus on him. Don't focus on your worldly affairs. Don't focus on what are the things to do. Give the best of your time to the Lord and focus on him. He will allow you to see as he comes to visit you. What did he allow Abraham to see? Now, Abraham sees in faith because he is the one who believes. He believes God exists and he believes that God wants to reward his faith. If I found favor in your eyes, don't pass me by. See the readiness, the willingness to wait on him and wait for him until he comes through. That's favor. God comes to impart a gift because we have been found in favor with the Lord. Now, the way Abraham lavished upon the Lord. Now, can we turn back to the PowerPoint? Let's look at the PowerPoint and we'll see this. Now, he says, please, there are three things. Please let a little water be brought and wash your feet. Now, in a hot sun, hot day, I mean, with such a hot sun, when people travel, you know, usually those people wear their kind of a sandals type of shoes, you know? And when you walk, the road is dry and it is very dusty. In the New Testament, in Jesus' time, all those people who want to go into another person's house, they must have their feet washed and cleaned by the servants. Then they will be brought into the house. That is a custom of hospitality and refreshing. That's according to the law. You know, to lavish upon your guests. Now, Abraham said, I want to lavish upon you and let your feet be washed, let you feel comfortable and welcomed. Now, this is giving refreshings to the Lord. Number two, rest yourselves under the tree. Now, tree has shade, you know. Rest yourself, meaning this is the place where you can find your dwelling. Stay here for a while. Now, Abraham's thought is, you come and rest because you have walked such a journey. Be refreshed, rest up. This is a safe place and a resting place, so that you can lodge. Under the tree, which tree? The place where Abraham has his altar for the Lord God. It is at the place of altar. We know from Malachi chapter 1 verse 7, when God talked about the altar, he said, that's my table. In the New Testament, Jesus said, that's my table. We know from Psalm 23, you know, the Lord spread in front of us his banquet table before our enemies. Now, that we may sit with Jesus Christ at the place of the altar, at the place of the table, and that's presenting the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. We come fellowship with the living God as we come to the place of altar, as we surrender ourselves, says Romans chapter 11, verses 1 and 2, as we surrender ourselves and sacrifice ourselves to come before the altar of God as a living sacrifice. It is a rightful worship. It is a place where we may meet with God. And at that place, we know the table of the Lord speaks about the body and the blood of Jesus. And it speaks about the banquet of life, an eternal life, and healing. Oh, and the presence of the Lord. That's powerful, powerful, powerful. And then he says, number three, I will bring a morsel of bread that you may refresh your hearts. Abraham touches deep into the heart of God. Now, those are the angels of God coming. And most likely they be Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. You may refresh your hearts. Why? That God may be well satisfied in dwelling with people. That's God Emmanuel. God can be with his people. Refresh your hearts. After that, you may pass by inasmuch as you have come to your servant. Now the key is, as we go back to, let's look at Genesis chapter 18. We're going to read from verse 5 on. Now when God comes, you learn to host his presence. That's what Abraham did. You host the presence of God. And so you carry the presence glory of God with you. Now, he says, let me give you something to eat. Here. Now that you have come to your servant, very well, they answered, do as you say. You know, God wants us to really receive his presence. And he wants to know how we want to treat him. Before a blessing will be released, Abraham hurried, you see? That's the speed of attending to God and to his agenda. Host the presence of God in your secret place with Him. Let Him talk. See Him. Refresh Him. Worship Him. Because you're surrendering yourselves at the place of altar before Him as a living sacrifice. And quickly refresh on the Lord. Quickly. He hurried. That's quickly. And then He select all the choice and the best things, you know, to present to the angels, to the Lord. He brought curds and milk, a calf that had been prepared, set before them. While they ate, now understand this, while they ate, he stood near them under a tree. You are attentive at the place of worship, because you want to hear what God wants to instruct you. And it's like a maidservant looking at the hand of the mistress intently. When the hand of the mistress moves, then the maidservant immediately will be there to attend to her need or requests. And then God said, now this is after, you know, they were refreshed. That means they fellowshipped with Abraham. As they have fellowshipped, God wants to reward his faith. Same as you host the presence of God and you welcomed Him and you attend to Him, He will speak an instruction to you. He will give you a word. Everybody say, a word from the Lord is eternal life. A word from the Lord has eternal power, and His word is established in heaven and is also established on the earth through Jesus Christ. So His word is sure. His word is His promise. His words are yes, yea, and amen. One word from the Lord settles all issues in your life. So this is the way. This is the invitation and the request of God asking us within this week to do this to Him, that He may impart to us a word. Now, what word did He impart to Abraham? He would impart a word to you at the place where you need Him most. Now, and God said, I will surely return to you. I will surely return. That's a guaranteed blessing. I will surely return to you about this time next year. Sarah, your wife, will have a son. But you know what? Sarah was barren. It doesn't matter if your condition is like totally, you know, impossible. Once you have a word, you need to know how to usher the, you know, and host the presence of the Lord God and welcome Him to come into your desperate situation. He wants to appear to you in your situation. Then you will never be the same again. The problem with Abraham and Sarah was they were barren, no children. And even when God says, I will surely return to you about this next year, your wife is going to have a son, it's like two way out, you know. They were already well advanced in years, so they don't think this is possible. But you know what the Lord said? The Lord said to Abraham, why did Sarah laugh and say, will I really have a child now that I am old? Doesn't matter how is your situation. Don't look at those impossibilities. You need to know how to usher in the voice of the Lord God into your situation. Miracles will happen. This is how miracle by a spoken word is going to take over your life. I should say overtake your life. Hallelujah. Now, God is saying this. Is there anything too hard for me? The answer is no. Is there anything too hard for the Lord? No. And He reiterated, meaning He said it again. He repeated to confirm Abraham's heart. I will return to you at the appointed time. Appointed time. Because Abraham has come into an appointed visitation of the Lord. God comes to appear to us, and He wants to come to appear to you. So be very careful to steward His presence throughout this week. Because once He drops a word to you, and once He reveals a vision to you, a dream to you, and speaks something to you, it means eternal blessing. It means a sure blessing that is going to overtake you. He says, I'm going to come back at the appointed time next year. Within 12 months, God is going to come and visit this 12 months. Hallelujah. He says now, your wife Sarah will have a son. God says, yes, you laugh. But God says, she will surely have a son from Abraham by the power of God. Amen. Now, and so the men got up. You see this? Abraham walked along with them and see them on their way. Then the Lord said, shall I hide from Abraham what I am about to do? Now, if you are a person who fellowships with the Lord God, understand this next thing. Not just only you're going to get a blessing for this coming year, God is also going to reveal His secret things, which He would not reveal to any other person on the earth. He is going to release it to you who steward His presence. Amen. Now let's go back to the PowerPoint. God comes to give you a gift of His word. Gift of a word in the form of a son. A son means by the word of God, it's going to produce. And it's going to produce, and the fruit that will come forth will be called laughter. And you will laugh over the situations. Hallelujah, of your previous conditions. Now, in Genesis 22, verses 11 to 24, here we see that God is bringing Abraham to a place of unending supply. Anybody wants to go there? The place of unending supply. There is a way to remain there. Hallelujah. Now, we know God spoke to Abraham from the beginning of chapter 22 and asked him to bring his son, that is Isaac. By promise, Abraham, after waited that 1 year, when he was 100, he received a son, you know? God revealed to him when he was 99, and after 1 year, he's 100, and he received the son. And now he's well advanced in years. And this Isaac now, that is the promised son, God says, bring him. I want you to sacrifice him to me. Abraham did what the Lord spoke to him. You see, the power of able to listen, the power of being able to listen to the voice of God. He knew that it was the Lord. He knew that it wasn't a confusion, that God wants to give a blessing and want to take away. No, he knew that it is God and He does not change. God promised Abraham, I shall make you a father of all nations. Through Isaac, God had spoken that. Abraham remembered. And he knew God would not contradict Himself. So now, he knew this seed now is to be sacrificed for the Lord in order for the promise to come about. Now, when Abraham brought the son, he asked the two servants now, and you know, to keep the donkeys somewhere and to wait for both of them. And then he said, we're going to come back after the worship. Now, this whole thing is called worship, you know. He says, we're going to go up and worship the Lord God. And then we're going to come back. So this whole thing that happened there is a worship. What kind of a worship? Abram lifted his eyes and look, there behind him was a ram caught in the thicket of his horns. So Abraham went and took the ram and offered it up for a burnt offering instead of his son. Because God said to him, now sacrifice your son to me. He really went and prepared the woods so that he can light up the fire and all that. And he really tied up his son and put up on the altar to slaughter. His heart fully obeyed God by the faith action. Faith without action is dead. Amen? If you just keep talking and you don't work on it, or you don't walk in the way of the Lord, it's empty. It's false believing. Now Abraham acted in faith, and the angel of the Lord came and stopped him and said, stop! Do no harm to the child. So God provided for Abraham. Let's take a look at it from Genesis chapter 22, from verse 10. We're going to take a look at the scripture from Genesis 22, verse 10. But the angel of the Lord called up to him from heaven, Abraham, Abraham. He said, here I am. Do not lay a hand on the boy. Do not do anything to him. Now, if God wants you to do something and you feel it is life-threatening, or if you feel that it is strongly hurtful, please believe that God is all good. He's not like human being. The concept to overcome all things is to know how great God is and how good God is. Your concept of God must be of His size. You must know Him from what He says He is. He is love. Many people fall at this point and will say, what kind of a God is this? That means they don't believe God is love. They don't believe God is all good. They don't believe God wants to bless them. So watch for this point. If you want to go into the blessing of the Lord God, God may ask you to do something which seems like is impossible or is too much of a demand on you. Begin to worship and thank Him and say, Lord, I understand this is what you said. You can say, please give me confirmation. You know, He doesn't mind you asking for confirmation. At the witness of two or three, this matter shall be established. But if you say, no, this is not God. But before He said this to you, and you say no now, God is contradicting Himself. Then this is man's suspicion. God did say to Abraham, through your son Isaac, I will make you into a father of many nations. Now God does not change. He's all good. He has promised. And He wants to bless. Now Abraham hears this instruction of sacrificing his son before the Lord. Then he believes, oh, you are such a wonderful God. Even if you demand that the blessing be sacrificed, you will still bless me through this my son. After he's did, then what happened? Well, then you have to raise him up in order to fulfill your promise to me. He fully believed God can raise Isaac from the dead because God is faithful. You say, he said this. He doesn't change. This is the kind of faith God wants from us. That we will believe this is what He said and this is it. God does not change. He is faithful. He is all good. If you have something you don't understand in between, it's not because God is not good. It's not because God has not spoken. It's because you do require something to understand it. You say, Father, you just worship Him. To fill in the gap is to worship Him and say, Father God, though I don't understand this, I just want to make sure this is from You, and You are all good, and let Your will be done. And you just obey Him. That's worship. That's worship. No complaint, you know, because she knows who God is. Now, the angel now appeared. When? After Abraham's faith is confirmed to know. He must be the God who is able to provide, because when he brings the son to go up onto the mountain, he says to the servants, we're going to worship, we are going to come back. Who are going to come back? We are going to come back. He wants to go and witness how his son died and resurrected from the dead, because God is faithful to bless him through this son. No matter how he was dead, God is going to give him back to him in order to fulfill God's promise. That means he believed God is so faithful. He believed in the faithfulness of God more than anything, more than any comment. This is faith. So the angel shows up. Now I know that you fear God because you have not withheld from me your son, your only son. The act is to confirm Abraham. God knew before time, you know? And then Abraham looked up. Now this is spiritual scene. God touched Abraham because when the ram was caught at the thicket by the horns, Abraham did not even notice. He was just paying attention to try to satisfy God's will. Now, he saw a ram caught by its horns. Horns means a position of power. The ram caught by his horn. This is a symbolic image of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, caught in the position of power, willing to surrender to the plan of God and to become one that is going to die for Abraham's sin and Abraham's seed. Now this is powerful. It speaks about those who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, like Abraham did. When we receive Jesus as our personal Lord and Savior, then we have eternal life. You know something? There's a scripture that comes. I'm going to just look at it. John chapter 8, I think. I'm going to look for it. Because that scripture says, Jesus himself said, he said, before Abraham, he says, I am. Now that's powerful. Jesus said, Abraham saw my day. So when Abraham was looking over there, what did Abraham see? He see how God would put his son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross, and how Jesus Christ died for us, and how Jesus Christ then must be resurrected. It's a powerful thing. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. Yes, we're going to get there. I want to make sure that we get the point. Now, there it is. Let's turn to John 8. It's 56, not 53. Okay. 56. John 8:56. John 8:8. Now this is what Jesus said about Abraham. Abraham rejoiced. Now that's great joy. At the thought. Now this is powerful. At the thought of seeing my day. He saw it and was glad. Now, what did Abraham see? He saw the ram caught in the thicket by the horns. He He saw Jesus, the preparation by God in order to replace Abraham's only seed at that time by his rightful wife. So this is very, very powerful. Abraham, at that point, he does not have the New Testament. He only hears the audible voice of God speaking to him. That's more powerful than anything. You know, he can rejoice at the thought of seeing Jesus died and resurrected. He sees the day of resurrection. He sees the ram being the Son of God, provided to replace the Son of Man in order to die the death, pay the penalty, to fulfill the law, and be resurrected to give us the blessing. He saw it, he was glad. Now that's a huge range of seeing down the thousands of years, you know? Oh, amazing. Now let's go back to the scripture, to Genesis chapter 22. It's okay, we'll just go here. And Abraham sacrificed the ram, representing God sends his son Jesus to die. And now Abraham called the name of that place, the Lord will provide. Where is the place where you can receive from heaven? The unending supply in the mountain of the Lord, it shall be provided where? At the place you are willing to not trust in your own ability, that you may have a son to provide for you or to continue your generation, your posterity? No. It is at the place where you believe Jesus died for you and he has come and taken all the unfortunate circumstances out of you and he gives his blessings instead. It is at the place of Abraham's full surrender to the voice of God. Who may receive the most from the Lord? The one who believes. Anytime you believe, you access. Anytime you believe, you access. Where? Through Jesus Christ. Through his blood shed for you. That you tell him your circumstance. God, I'm in this desperate, dire situation. And you, the Lord says, apply the blood. The Lord says, let my blood speak for you. And the Lord says, decree in the blood. Jesus has taken all that situations for you. Because he has taken the sin that invited those situations. And Jesus has taken them all. And now the provisions of God come. Amen? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And then God pronounced an eternal blessing for the line of salvation. Everyone who is like him can be saved. That's a powerful way of surrender. At the place of your surrender, you not only save yourself, but also many others to come down the generation. Then the angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time out of heaven and said, by myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this thing and have not withheld your son, your only son. Blessing, I will bless you, Abraham himself. And for the descendants, multiplying, multiplication. And multiply, I will multiply your descendants. So I want to present to you this. Once you believe in God and you receive his blessing, begin to release it and implant it to somebody. Multiplication will happen. If you just keep it to yourself and do it yourself, no multiplication, only blessings. Once you release it, multiplication. Blessings, blessing, I will bless you. Multiplication, I will multiply your seed, your descendants, as the stars of the heaven, and as the sand which is on the seashore, and your descendants shall possess the gate of the enemies. That's overcoming all the devil. Because Jesus said in Matthew 16:23, that the gates of hell will not prevail against the word of God, the revelation of God. The gates of hell cannot prevail against revelation. What God has spoken, what God has revealed, what God has blessed. In your seed, all the nations of the earth will be blessed because you have obeyed my voice. one and most important thing. Do strive, do anything that you can do to obey the voice of God. Because that's entering into rest. Strive to enter into rest, not do anything on your own. Hear his voice, then do it. Amen? Hear his voice, then do it. Now, God is also speaking to us about the power of his word is coming forth. God wants to come, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, to fellowship with us. We know that's John 14, verse 20, 21. See, Jesus said, for those who obey my commandments, I will come to fellowship with you, and my Father too, to fellowship with you. So Jesus and the Father, by the power of the Holy Spirit, will come and fellowship with us. So I present to you, now is the time that God is readily available to fellowship with us. Welcome, host him. Amen? And begin to receive from him what he wants to show you and act on it. Oh, it will be amazing. Now, hear this situation about the widow of a prophet who extended hospitality. Now, this is about also well receiving the word. In Abraham's case, you see angels of God, you know? Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, angel come, you know? Now, this one is in the presence of a word, in the form of a word. Now, 2 Kings 4, 3 to 7, we know this widow of a prophet. The prophet died, the widow has two sons, and then she was in great debt. And then the debtors now want to come and say, we're going to take your sons as a payment for, you know, for whatever debt you have. And then she quickly went to the prophet of God. Oh, let's take a look at it. 2 Kings chapter 4, from verse 3 to 7. We're going to read from verse 1 in order to give you a picture. Now the widow came before the servant of the Lord God, and the servant of God was asking him, you know, what is the matter with you? She said, she has nothing. The husband has died, and now the debtors want to take the two sons away from her. Yes. Your servant, my husband, is dead, and you know that he revered the Lord, but now his creditor is coming to take my two boys and his as his slaves. Now the devil wants to come to reduce the people of God to slavery and even more to sin. Now debt is a spirit. The spirit of owing, you know. The spirit that has no morality, basically. A spirit of debt. Elisha replied to her, how can I help you? Now understand this. Once you come before the Lord, God always wants to help his people. Amen? He is our stronghold, high tower. He is our refuge place. Our help in times of trouble. Our help in times of trouble. Now, God is presenting himself as a help, even through the word spoken by his prophet. How can I help you? Tell me, what do you have in your house? Now, this is very important. This is a change of perspective in your scene. The woman said, I have nothing at all, except for a little oil. Now, that's a lying concept, but she cannot receive anything from God. She cannot go further from what she can see. You see? She cannot go further from what she can believe. The woman see the physical reality and reported the physical reality and say she has nothing except for just a little bit of oil. Because the question is, tell me. You tell me what you have. From the words, understand me, from the words you would speak, an instruction will be given to you. She says she has nothing except for a little bit of oil. She cannot see that as she believes in God, even the husband has been a prophet, that she can receive anything from heaven. Because the scripture says, ask and you shall receive, seek and you will find, knock and the door shall be opened unto you. If you ask for a fish, will God give you a serpent, a snake? No. If you ask for bread, will he give you a stone? No. And he said, you who are wicked know how to give good things to your children. That means people who have fallen into sin, they also know how to give good things to what they think is a good thing to their children. How much more, Father God? If you ask him, he's going to give you his Holy Spirit. Now that's powerful. You have the Holy Spirit of God, you have everything in the kingdom of God. Tell me, what do you have? She has not engaged the word because she thinks she doesn't have. So she has to come to the servant of God, and the servant of God has to remind her to check and see what you have. Everybody say, I must present something to the Lord so that he can do something with it. I cannot present to God nothing and expect him to work on it. You know, Jesus blessed 5,000 men with two fish and two and five loaves. And the disciples said, wow, you know, there's so many of them. Send them home. Send them home. They need to go home and buy something to eat. Jesus said, you give them something to eat. We don't have anything. You know what Jesus said? Go and check. Funny thing is, they check themselves and they find, you know, very little bit of thing. They were very interested in a boy's lunch. Two fish and five loaves. They were eyeing on that thing, you know. And the boy is willing to share. So they got that and they gave to Jesus, you know. Don't mind what little bit of thing you can give to Jesus. Hallelujah. Just give him something. Yes. To work with. For your good. Hallelujah. You know, one thing I want to mention. A lot of people think, a lot of people outside think, oh, you go to church, you make a donation. And you go to the church, you give something to tip God. God will be laughing. You know why? He says, what you can give me is always a seed. And then I must release the proportionate measure of the harvest to you. You give five, he says, I will times 100 because I need to give you 100-fold. And you receive more than what you can even have as a seed. When people learn the way how God will multiply, oh, they will rush to the church to give. This is true. The Lord is amazing. We need to know how he is amazing, you know? So even with a little bit of oil, you think it's nothing? God can produce something out of this little thing. So what did God do? Elisha said, now this is an instruction. When you tell God, you have this little thing, you know? Don't say, oh God, I don't have this, I don't have that. Don't talk to him. You say, God, I believe in you. I have this. What should I do with it? Ah, then he's going to say something to you. Go around. Ask. A-L-L is all. That means don't go to only 75 houses. Go to the full 100 houses. You see what I'm saying? If you want to obey the instruction of God, obey it fully. Fully, fully. Ask all your neighbors for empty jars. Don't ask for just a few. That's the instruction. Then go inside and shut the door behind you and your sons. Pour the oil into the jars, and as each is filled, put it to one side. Now that's a whole long instruction given to the widow. A few things now. They go inside. Once you receive a word from God, don't tell anyone when it is in process. share with only those who are with you who are affected by the debt condition. You know? So you just do a closed door situation, the woman and the two sons inside, and they just do what God through his prophet instructed them to do. Now it says here, pour oil into all the jars, and as each is filled, put it to one side. Do you know when the woman hears this, what she may think? I have this little bit of oil. She said, I have this little oil, remember? But the instruction says, pour it into how many jars? She says, she's this little oil in one little small jar. Pour it into all the jars. The faith seen from the Word of God. You need to see a different picture if you want to come out from your condition. You need to believe and keep speaking and welcoming the God Word picture and have it fill your heart and be convinced that this is from God. Pour that oil into all the jars, because you need to go, don't get a few jars, go to all your neighbors, A-L-L, you know? And as each one is filled, the prophet saw the oil is pouring and pouring and pouring nonstop. The woman did not see. Now, the woman has to drop what she thinks, what she expects, what she has. She has to drop all of that and to believe the impossible word from the Lord God and say, this jar of mine is going to pour and it's going to continue pouring. And that oil is going to fill all the jars, and then I have to fill them and put them on one side. Will you believe in what the Lord tells you? And take his word picture and drop your life reality picture. The woman's eyes physically see a small jar with a little bit of oil. But her faith seeing is so much greater than that. Faith seeing sees into the realm of God to see all the abundance of God readily available at any time. God is inviting us to go into this. Hallelujah. She left him. Now this is powerful. Why did she leave him? Because she knew it is the way out and she believed. She received the word. Is as good as her debts are already paid for, the creditors are already gone, and she is living a lifestyle fully provided for. The word. She doesn't need to look at the prophet Elisha, you know? She doesn't need the Elisha to stand next to her. No. Don't bring the prophet home with you. Bring the word of God with you. Amen? When God says it is to bring his word with you. She left him and afterwards shut the door behind her and her sons. They brought the jars to her and she kept pouring. She kept pouring. You know, one time I was told this testimony. A woman now and her husband, they went to their cottage place in some place of America. And because of something happened, it's either a landslide or earthquake or something, somehow the only road that goes to that place was kind of cracked, you know? So they cannot go home. And they waited for rescue. So what she has now, whatever in the fridge, they keep eating, you know, and finish up. And now she has left with only one can of oatmeal. And she kept, you know, pouring that and eating that and cooking for the husband. And after some time, that thing is getting low. You know what the lady said? She said, every day in the morning, I just know that God provides for us. She opens up the lid. She didn't even look. She just scooped. And she knew something is pouring into the bowl. And she knew there's something there. And then she cooked for herself and she cooked for her husband. They were in that situation for a bit of time. She knew there should be nothing in that container. But you know what? By faith, she said, "Thank you, Lord Jesus," and it came, you know? There is another testimony we heard from an elderly couple from China. You know, one time, somebody came to their, you know, small little place to visit, because the husband was a preacher, you know? And so, he said, there's so many people coming to visit, 19 people. And they all sat around, and it was packed. And then he told the wife, "We need to get them something to eat, because it's probably customary for them to, you know, whoever comes, you serve with something, you know?" So she went to the kitchen now, and she was thinking, there was just only, you know, one handful of rice, which, I mean, she always take one handful of rice and cook porridge. The rice is cooked with water, you know, porridge. And I share with her husband, half a bowl for him and half a bowl for her. And then they are going to cook some vegetable and something to eat. So now there are 19 people there, and they were just coming to visit out of the blue, and so attentive to the husband's preaching. So she's in the kitchen, and she was like, what to do? She looked, she has two little small fish. She said, no matter what, we don't have anything else, just put it in the wok, you know. She has a wok, put it in the wok to steam and cook that little fish. She said, once she testified, when she put the lid on, lots of steam came out. And she was like, wow, what happened? And she quickly opened it, and there was two large fish. They came out from that thing, you know? And she was like, oh, miracle. She took the miracle fish, put it aside. And she said, she has a handful of vegetable. Maybe I should put it in also, you know? Put it in the plate and put it in there. And when she covers the lid, same thing happened. Steam came up. She opened the lid quickly, and there was this huge plate of vegetables. And she's like, okay, now God has performed miracles. What about the rice, you know? So she went over with that little pot thing, and the rice was cooked. She didn't even look at it. She said, I just scoop and pour it. Scoop and pour it. And just scoop and just keep scooping, you know? She realized that there's something there. 19 plus 2 is 21 bowls of rice. And they ate, and they have enough. Now the other case, this is real cases now. Real cases. The other case is a lady whose husband said he's going to bring three or four friends to come. So she cooked a chicken, you know, in the oven, nice. And with all this ready vegetables and whatnot. And so when it's ding dong, you know, the door opens. Close to 20 people come. And the husband said, they wanted to come, so I have no time to mention to you, but let's, you know, sit and eat and just do with what we have. She went into the kitchen, one chicken on the table, you know? And then she put it in, and she put it onto the table, and then all the vegetables and whatnot. And so somebody was prayer blessing. God, thank you for all the foods. One plate, one chicken. She handed to the person next to her. Wow, chunk, one chunk is gone, you know? And then she's like, I just cannot see what's going to happen to the rest. Everybody was happy. Everybody took a huge chunk. And it went around everybody's plates. Everybody's plates were full. And when it came to her, the plate was too heavy. She had to sit the whole thing down and take some for herself. The leftover, 3 days they have to eat chicken. When you believe, you're going to see miracles happen. Hallelujah. Just believe. Amen. Now, the lady kept pouring. That means there's something we need to know. when God started to open up something for you, if you don't say, I have it enough, it's not going to stop. Remember? Yes. When Jesus fed the 5,000, when did the food stop multiplying? When? The scripture says, when everybody had all that they want to have, to the full, they couldn't take any one small bite anymore. And then it says it stopped. Same here, she kept pouring now, you know? Bring all the jars, bring more, bring more, bring another one, you know? There is not a jar left. Then it stopped flowing. You understand what I'm saying? You know something good about the gospel? I tell you, once you begin to speak the gospel, once you begin to start something, you know, for example, even for us who have started giving clothing to the third world, I say, Father God, I experienced that. If I say more should be coming or expecting more and keep giving, it won't stop. But there was one time, you know, just a thought. I say, Father God, oh yeah, I never like to wear turtleneck, by the way. Somehow that day, you know, I don't know what happened to me. I just say, I like to have some turtlenecks. Maybe, you know, it's good to keep warm. I don't know what, but so I said it. Then a phone call came and said, Pastor Grace, we have something for you. I said, what is it? Turtlenecks. Would you like turtlenecks? Oh yeah, I like one, I said. Came a whole bag. I'm like, what is different sizes? Turtlenecks. Wow, different colors. And I go, wow, the Lord is great. So I gave away, you know, I gave away all the rest of it. Oh, I tell you, once I begin to give away, more is coming. Hello, Pastor Grace. Some factory here, they have new clothings, but they say they want to change season and they want to give it all away. Would you like them? Ew, with the price tag on. I said, not for me, but I'm thinking, maybe it's good to give to whoever, you know? If I keep doing it, it will not stop. I understand that from the principle of the Word of God. So I know, if I start a healing service and I do not stop, the healing river of God will flow. And will flow non-stop. Amen? And I know, if you start doing something for the Lord, you just keep doing it. Watch, everything is flowing in that direction. Hallelujah? You understand what I'm saying? God is saying to people in Favor International Church, I come to give you favor, as Abraham said. If I have found favor with you, please stay with me. And God bless. Now, Abraham has sons and daughters and sons and daughters and up to all the generations, you know? Non-stop. As long as there are people on the earth, non-stop. Here it is. Bring me another one, please. Empty jars. Because she knows now, she better get as many. Well, no more left. Then the last drop, she doesn't have to be worried about, you know, what if there's excess? Go to the bathtub, you don't know. Stop. God's timing is amazing. God's work is amazing. Nothing stopped flowing because there's no more need. Now understand what happens here. She quickly went and told the man of God. And the man of God say, now that's a second instruction. God will not give you the next instruction if you have not finished the first one. You understand what I'm saying? Yes, don't play cool with the Lord. If you haven't finished the first instruction, you will not hear the second instruction. Now she has to go back to get the word, you know? So we need to seek the kingdom of God and His righteousness first, feed on His word. all that you need, I tell you, the Bible did not say you need to pray about what you need. It just say automatically it will be added to you. So you just keep doing what God is calling you to do. Wait and watch all the provisions following you and to overtake you. You don't have to ask for it. That's the Bible. You see, seek the kingdom of God and His righteousness. All these things, all these that you need, N-E-E-D, shall be added unto you. We know from Matthew chapter 6. Let me finish early today. Matthew chapter 6 talks about, you know, what to eat and what to wear, and all of that, what to drink. The Lord says, the pagans, the Gentiles, they pursue these things. Why are you pursuing these things? Father God knows what you need, right? Yes. If Father God knows what you need, when it comes the right time, He gives it. When it comes the right time, He gives it. You're just busy doing the works of God, and you turn around, oh, that's what you need is there. You turn around, oh, that's what you need is there also. Hallelujah. Now, she went in, shut the door, and she got lots. And then, now, when it comes to pass, the vessels were full. She said to her sons, bring another vessel, bring, no more. The oil ceased. Now, what did the man of God tell her? Go. Two times, it's go. Don't just stay there with the prophet. You get the word, go. Get the word, go and what? Practice it. Get the word, go and practice it and see the miracle. Practice it and see the miracle. Hallelujah. Now, go, the instruction is sell the oil and pay your debts. I tell you, if she would only get a few, she will regret at this point. Because the amount of the money that would come in depends on the obedience to the instruction of the prophet that says, go to all your neighbors. When you want to listen to the word of God, you must obey carefully, word for word. Word for word. All means everyone that you know is a neighbor. Go get them. Because as you fully obeyed, getting all the neighbors empty jars, sell the oil. You see what I'm saying? Oh, let's go back. Let's turn to the scripture. Let's turn to this one. Can you turn to the your scripture on the online? Because I want to see the words there. It says, go sell the oil. Okay? It doesn't say go sell the vessels, okay? Yes. Go sell the oil and pay your debts. Now, you know, the powerful thing is, you and your sons can live on what is left. I think that's powerful. No matter how many jars are there, but it's all the jars that she can get. All the rest of her life and their sons' lives are provided for. Do you see that? Sell the oil and pay your debts. After that, you can have leftover. That's abundant provisions from the Lord God. Hallelujah. You sell the oil and you give the jar back to your neighbors. And your neighbors will be wondering, yes, what happened to you? You didn't tell your testimony yet, right? And then you sell the next jar. And then you get other jars coming in. You pour your oil in there, and then you give all your neighbors the jars back. They will be asking, what happened to you? Then you tell your testimony. Hallelujah. I listened. I went to the man of God. And the man of God said God's word. I obeyed. And I become blessed. And I can come out of debt by obeying the word of God. You see? You obey God, you come out of debt. obey his instruction, you come out of debt. And you have abundant provisions that you can live with. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Let's go back to the PowerPoint. Father God, I thank you. I think we should stop here. I want to mention, God gives us, in his visitation, he can give you a gift of a word. Treasure that word. In all your getting, you know, get wisdom and get understanding. In all your getting, come before the Lord God and say, Father God, I'm here to worship you. I'm here to give you all of what I can lavish upon you. And I tell you, as you are doing the lavishing on the Lord, he will give you something great. And you will experience the God of provision. Jehovah Jireh. Jireh. J-I-R-E-H. Jehovah Jireh, basically. Yeah. The God who supplies. Unending supply at any time. If you can connect heaven and open that faucet, once it's open, it's for a lifetime. Just like favor. Favor has come upon me and it's non-stop releasing, so it's a lifetime. Because it's from heaven. Oh, Father God, we praise you. We thank you, Lord, because all things that you give us is from the eternal source. It will outlast the globe. And we are so thankful. For in any situations, you are calling us today to go through this week, to embrace your presence, to host your presence, and to know how to steward your presence, so that we may walk in that path that is of great abundance, dripped with honey and dripped with the anointing of the Lord God, that he butters the steps of our feet. Oh, thank you, Lord. Father, Lord, we thank you. We ask that now you will touch your children to know this is the timing for this. And God is knocking on our doors. And you go and receive from the Lord. And even as you meditate on these words and begin to see what God wants to show you, and when he gives you an instruction, you will prosper in it. I release this to the people of God in Favor International Church and for those who are watching. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's worship him in truth and in spirit.
May your spirit Thank you.
The presence of the Lord God is right here with us. Let's receive His benediction from the throne room of God. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord turn His face toward you and grant you His peace. Shalom. In Jesus' name, Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. We have a few announcements. I sense the glory presence of the Lord is so great in our midst. Every Thursday at 7 p.m., we have a bilingual service, which is called the Hour of Victory, which is a healing and deliverance service here. We welcome you to come into the already established reality of how Jesus died on the cross and finished all the works of sin and death and hell and every wicked things, including curses, including sickness and disease, they are all removed from us. So come before the cross and come to see Jesus and you shall be healed. Amen. And the next announcement is insights for the week. What Father God puts in my heart concerning this coming week. Prophetically, I'm going to say to you in this week so that by next week, this coming week, you will be able to walk in the presence and the Word of God as we agree and pray together according to the Word of God. And the Father God says, we're going to do this until rapture. Thank you, Jesus. Now, baptism for everyone who has accepted Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. I welcome you to come talk to me We're going to make arrangements for baptism, lots of baptisms this year. And we give all the glories and praise to the Lord for every soul saved. And if you are one of them and you are, you have this heart to want to follow Jesus Christ and you want to acknowledge Him for the rest of your life, before men and before God. So you can come and talk with me and I can make arrangements for you so that you can give that glory to the Lord Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. So before we see you next time, remember to plead the blood of Jesus over the doorposts and the door frames of your heart. And declare Psalm 91 into your atmosphere. God will put asunder all your enemies. Have a great and blessed, expecting great miracles week. Amen. Amen. See you next time.